I'll ramble.
Nicely done.
Here we go.
here. Another.
Oh, look! It's Skoll and Hati, the giant wolves who chase the sun and moon.
Quite right, my boy.
Where did they come from? How did they get up there?
Well, it's a long story, but we'll get to it.
What's happening there at the end? They eat the sun and moon? And then everybody fights?
I suppose that's one way to put it.
Be in here?
Lost? Nah. Ah, more of those. Good. To next.
Mind the edge, boy.
Next. wish Mom were here. Why is Odin so desperate to find a way into Jotunheim anyway?
He's convinced the giants hold the key to changing his fate when Ragnarok comes. They are the Aesir's oldest enemies, after all. And it's their army that's supposed to do him in the end. But more than that, he covets their gifts of prophecy. He wants to know what they know and see what they see. So much suffering could have been avoided if his insatiable curiosity was not so much stronger than his wisdom.
What do you mean?
Ah, remind me to tell you why they call him the Lord of the Hanged.
Why do they call Odin the Lord of the Hanged?
That refers to a modest example of Odin's thirst for knowledge. The time he spent 9 days a dead man. Hung himself by the neck from Yggdrasil's branches, put his spear through his own side, and bled down into the Well of Destiny. He roamed the realms of the dead and plundered the World Tree of its secrets, until I think, quite rightly, it got fed up with him and sent him back to the Land of the Living. Did I not mention he was barking mad?
Sort you out.
I wish Mom were here.
Something for the boy? You got a fine deal there.
Which way?
Time for another break, anyways.
It's a tricky thing, lad. Odin's just arrogant enough to think he can get the best of it.
Fate is another lie told by the gods. Nothing is written that cannot be unwritten.
On that, brother, you and the Allfather may just agree. Even if he can't prevent Ragnarok, he still hopes to learn enough details to influence the outcome. Remind me later to tell you about the rules. Ah, mystics, gentle breeze, and the sweet smell of honeysuckle and blood. Well, judging by the sky, the light elves are in control of the light this time.
Explain.
You see, the light elves and dark elves
are always fighting over the light. That part we know.
But did you also know that control of the light has changed hands no less than 213 times?
Really?
It's true. Each side believes itself the rightful keepers of the light and argue they're simply fighting for survival. But the fact of the matter is, the war has been going on so long, they don't know who they are without it.
That's showing him.
else? Nah.
To see. Why is it so cold? I'm serious. This is unreasonable. I've seen enough. We can turn back now. Right behind you.
Hmm.
Great. We're done here? We can leave? We can go home now? Be warm?
Oh,